helping the most vulnerable in our clinic get access to the care that they need. We have over 300 community pharmacists in the station. What does that mean? Pharmacists are accessible. They're often available at times when other healthcare service providers might not be, so weekends and evenings, and they're dispersed across the station. Pharmacists are medication experts. Did you know that medications are the most commonly used technologies in healthcare? It's estimated that over 75% of doctor visits end in a prescription for medication. It's also estimated that 41% of candidates age 6 to 79 years of age have taken a medication in the last 2 days. So all these prescriptions come to pharmacy. I think there are connotations to what a pharmacist might do. Count, stick away, walk in, pour from one bottle to another. But we play critical roles in medication management, and we're engaging in these services, such as prescription, for example. I could see that pharmacists also play an invaluable role in mental health care. It seems like a natural fit. Medications are very commonly employed interventions in mental health care for getting people to get well, stay well. Say if these 300 prescription bottles represent all of us in this room tonight, those red 20 men represent the folks that take care of people. This brings us well, and when we do a quote, Carrie Fisher, she says, I'm fine down with you, I'm on seven medications, and I take medication 3 times a day. This constantly puts me in touch with the illness I have, and never put a letter to be free again for a day. I bet you each one of us has similar to Carrie Fisher, because mental illness is common. Our 48-year-old friends here, well, based on some statistics, need a day, or experience mental illness, so I can assure you. And on Scotia, 200,000. And this room tonight is about 300 of us, 60 people. So mental illness is common and has lots of hope to go around. So as a pharmacist, I'm interested in how many patients are used and mental illness. Why are they not used enough? Sometimes why they're used too much. And that's part of the story we're going to hear to talk to you tonight. However, I want to stress that medications are often imperative in the recovery of people with mental illness and addictions. It helps them on the road to get well and stay well. So, 7 years ago, I worked with families and youth with mental illness. One thing that I recognized was that medications such as antipsychotics seem to be used more frequently than I would expect. Talking to colleagues, looking into the literature, I couldn't quite make sense of it, but still had unanswered questions. So we studied it. And we did indeed find that community services recipients in our association, the rates of antipsychotic prescriptions were higher than we expected, however, it was on par with the national trend. So then we did some qualitative work because we wanted to talk to physicians, we wanted to talk to parents, we wanted to talk to youth. What we found is that sometimes medications were used as band-aids or a bridge to another service. Youth had significant gaps in knowledge, and the parents actually could have used a bridge to have more support. So being a pharmacist, I said, how can we as pharmacists help? Not just these folks using antipsychotics. And we started the Morgan Best program with a small number of pharmacies to build capacity with pharmacists working with people with lived experience in mental illness in the communities. We wanted to make things better for access to care. One of the striking findings for us that we might not have a population of people is that pharmacists built amazing bridges with people in their communities, and what we recognized was there's power in the people in terms of recognizing and knowing where the resources are in their communities, and we were able to help the pharmacists and pharmacists as well. This is a resource that we developed for the people in the community, and it's called the Navigator. The Navigator is used by pharmacists and their patients to help patients find resources in their communities. Mary, for example, was a patient who was caring for a husband with dementia. She actually needed help and access to services in her community, and by going to the Navigator with the pharmacist, they were able to find some supports for him. So all these lessons learned we've put into our BOOM program, which is a program similar to principle and philosophy to my clients. Pharmacists are working with people with lived experience to make care more accessible and better in their communities. This is an example of a library that the BOOM program requires in the pharmacy setting. One of our pharmacists in Cape Breton had put out a lot of references about sleep, and we recognized that in this community, people wanted more advice about sleep, so we doctors to work together to improve sleep quality and also decrease the use of sleep medicines. Another study that I usually relate to is the community pharmacist role in suicide. Some of you may be aware that medications are commonly used in suicide attempts. Pharmacists have been required, sometimes only fly, to help people who are presenting in the situation. This wasn't universal because people with lived experience with mental illness have been telling us for a long time. Frontline care workers, life pharmacists, need to have the knowledge and skills to be able to help refer people when they present in crisis situations. So now we're working on that. Now, all of this work that we've been doing certainly changed. Doesn't come without challenges, and turbulent seas. But we look to the present lessons learned and also to the future to see that rainbow, and we strive to do things better and try to do things differently. And I'm hoping that with the examples I've given you tonight, you can see that pharmacists are more than just health, sick, poor. So, what I'd like to also say is that I started by saying that I hope for healthcare is that all disciplines are working to their full scope of practice and collaborative patient centered care. The force is strong in pharmacists. Benefit we will when they are all the best. Thank you.